गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम क्लास टेंथ फिजिक्स के इलेक्ट्रिसिटी क्लास के नोट्स पढ़ेंगे। इलेक्ट्रिसिटी इज़ ए फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी यूज इन आवर होम्स एंड इंडस्ट्रीज टू मेक आवर वर्क इजियर। टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस, देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस, पॉजिटिव चार्ज और निगेटिव चार्ज। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वैन वी रब ए ग्लास रॉड विद ए सिल्क क्लोथ, देन द चेंज एक्वायर बाय द रॉड इज निगेटिव। Property of electric charge. The property of electric charges is opposite charges attract each other, whereas like charges repel each other. The SI unit of charge is coulomb. It is denoted by C. In all matters, there are electrons and protons. Electrons are negatively charged particles and protons are positively charged particles, both having a charge of 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19 coulomb. One coulomb is equivalent to the charges of 6.25 into 10 to the power 18 electrons. Types of substance. On the basis of flow of electric charge, substance are divided into two types, conductors and insulators. Conductors, the substance through which electricity can flow are called conductors. For example, silver, copper and aluminium. Insulators, those substance through which electricity cannot flow are called insulators. For example, wood, plastic, etc. Note, the presence of free electrons makes the substance a conductor or insulator. More the number of free electrons present, more conductor will be the substance. Electric potential. The electric potential at a point is defined as the work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to that point. It is denoted by capital V. Potential difference. The potential difference between two points within the electric circuit is defined as the work done in moving a unit charge from one point to another. That is, potential difference is equal to work done upon quantity of charge moved. V is equal to W upon Q. V is equal to potential difference, W is equal to work done, Q is equal to quantity of charge moved. SI unit of potential difference is volt, denoted by capital V. 1 volt. The potential difference between two points is said to be 1 volt if the work done in moving 1 coulomb of charge is 1 joule. 1 volt is equal to 1 joule upon 1 coulomb. The instrument used to measure potential difference is voltmeter. Potential difference is also known as voltage. Electric current. The flow of electrons in a metal from one point to another is called electric current. SI unit of electric current is ampere. Current I is equal to Q upon T. 1 ampere. When 1 coulomb of charge flows through any cross section of a conductor in 1 second, then it is called 1 ampere. Instrument used to measure current is ammeter. 1 ampere equals to 1 coulomb upon 1 second. Direction of electric current. The conventional direction of electric current is from positive terminal of a cell to the negative terminal through outer circuit. Electric circuit, the path of wire and other resistance between two terminals of cell along which electric current flows is called a circuit. Various symbols of electric components. Electric component and symbol as shown in figure. Cell, battery, connecting wire, a wire joint, wire connecting crossing without contact, resistor, fixed value, variable resistance, resistant, ammeter, voltmeter, galvanometer, open switch, closed switch and electric bulb. Circuit diagrams. A diagram which indicates how different components in a circuit are connected in is called circuit diagram. Electricity always flows through closed circuit only. Ohm's law. At constant temperature, the current flowing through a conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference across its end. I is directly proportional to V at constant temperature. V is proportional to I. V is equals to I into R, where R is proportionality constant called resistance. R equals to V upon I. V upon I is potential difference upon current is equal to constant. Resistance of a conductor. The property of a conductor due to which it opposes the flow of current through it is called resistance. Resistance equals to potential difference upon current. R equals to V upon I. The resistance of a conductor depends on length, thickness, nature of material and temperature of the conductor. SI unit of resistance is ohm. The symbol of ohm is this. 1 ohm If a potential difference of 1 volt flows a current of 1 ampere, then the resistance of conductor will be 1 ohm. When we draw a graph between V and I, then it is a straight line, that is, current is directly proportional to the potential difference, as shown in figure. Good conductors. Those substances which have very low electric resistance are called good conductors. Resistors. Those substances which has comparatively high electric resistance are called resistors. Insulators. Those substances which have infinitely high electric resistance are called insulators. Factors affecting the resistance of a conductor. Resistance of a conductor depends upon length of conductor, area of cross section, nature of material and temperature of conductor. Number 1, R is directly proportional to L, that is, resistance is directly proportional to the length of wire. R is inversely proportional to A, resistance is inversely proportional to the area of cross section of wire. Resistance of different materials are different. Resistance of pure substance increases on increase in temperature. Resistivity. The resistivity of a substance is numerically equal to the resistance of a rod of that substance which is 1 meter long and 1 square meter in cross section. That is, R is directly proportional to L, R is inversely proportional to L 1 upon A. From 1 and 2, R is directly proportional to L upon A. R equals to rho L upon A, where rho is the resistivity of a substance. Rho equals to R into A upon L, that is, resistivity of a substance does not depend on its length or thickness. It depends on the nature of the substance and temperature. Its SI unit is ohm meter. Note, if we say that the resistivity of copper is 1.69 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter, we mean that if we take a rod of copper matter 1 meter long and 1 square meter in cross section, then its resistance will be 1.69 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm. Combination of resistance. We can combine the resistance in two ways, in series and in parallel. In series, when two resistances are connected end to end consecutively, they are said to be connected in series, just like is shown in figure. In parallel, when two resistances are connected between the same two points, they are said to be connected in parallel, shown in figure. Resultant resistance of two resistances connected in series. Figure is shown. Let two resistances R1 and R2 are connected in series in the circuit. Each resistance have same current I and the voltage of different distance are resistance are V1 and V2, and overall resistance and voltage are respectively R and V. Then V is equal to I into R, V1 is equal to I into R1, V2 is equal to I into R2, and we know that V equals to V1 plus V2 in series. Therefore, IR is equal to IR1 plus IR2. I is, that is, R is equal to R1 plus R2 in series. Combined resistance of two resistance connected in parallel. Figure is shown. Let two resistance R1 and R2 are connected in parallel in which current passing is I1 and I2 respectively, and the potential difference is V, and the resultant resistance V capital R. Then I is equal to V upon R1, V upon R, I1 is equal to V upon R1, I2 is equal to V upon R2. From 1 to 3, I is equal to I1 plus I2 in parallel. Therefore, V upon R equals to V upon R1 plus V upon R2. That is, 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 in parallel. Disadvantages of series circuit for domestic wiring. In series, if one appliance is stopped, all other appliances will also stop. All appliances have only one on or off switch. In series, all appliances do not get equal voltage of 220 volt. In series, overall resistance increases due to which current flows is low. Advantage of parallel circuit of domestic wiring. If one appliance is stopped, all other appliances work properly. Each appliance has its own on or off switch. Each appliance can be equal voltage of 220 volt. In parallel series, overall resistance becomes reduced due to which current flows is high. Electric power. It is defined as the electric work done per unit time. Power is equal to work done upon time taken. P is equal to W upon T. Unit of power. The SI unit of electric power is what? It is denoted by W. It is equal to the rate of working of 1 joule per second. That is, 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. Different formulas to calculate electric power. P equals to W upon T, where P equals to power, W is equal to work done, and T is equal to time taken. P is equal to V into I, where P is power, V is potential difference and I is current in ampere. P equals to I square into R, where P is power, I is current, R is resistance. P is also equals to V square upon R, where P is power, V is potential difference and R is resistance. Formula of electric energy. Electric energy is given as equals to power into time, that is E equals to P into T. The electric energy consumed by an electric appliance is given by the product of its power rating and the time for which it is used. Unit of electric energy is watt hour. 1 watt hour. 1 watt hour is the amount of electric energy consumed when an electric appliance of 1 watt power is used for 1 hour. Commercial unit of electric energy. Commercial unit of electric energy is kilowatt hour, which is defined as 1 kilowatt hour is the amount of electrical energy consumed when an electric appliance having a power rating of 1 kilowatt is used for 1 hour. Relation between kilowatt hour and joule. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 360000 joule, that is 3.6 × 10⁶ joule. Heating effect of current. When an electric current is passed through a high resistance wire like nichrome wire, the resistance will become very hot and produce heat. This is called the heating effect of current. Heat produced is equal to work done, that is H is equal to I square RT, where H is heat produced, I is current, R is resistance, T is time. This is called Joule law of heating. From the above formula, we conclude that H is directly proportional to I square, that is heat is directly proportional to the square of current, and H is directly proportional to R, that is heat is directly proportional to the resistance, and H is directly proportional to T, that is heat produced is directly proportional to the time taken. Application of heating effect of current. This is used in electric iron, electric kettle, etc. This is used in electric bulb. The filament of the bulb is made up of tungsten due to very high melting point. The gas filled in the bulb is argon or nitrogen or the mixture of both. This is used in electric fuse to protect the household appliances. That's all in this video.